You ready?
I am.
Because I'm going to clap. Right. Hi, guys. I'm Mia Voss, and we're doing a special show today with this gal that I absolutely love. You've seen her on my show a couple times, and we're going to be talking about dough for what you know. Just so you know, I didn't think it up. She did, too. So that's it. So welcome. Welcome, Fran Harris. Hey.
Hello. Thank you, darling. Thank you, darling.
How are you? Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to hit that twice, but, you know, that was from the audience.
It was a standing O. It was a standing O, so that's good.
You've seen them before. All right, so before we jump in, I want to get your, I want to hear your story real quick so everybody who's not seen you on my shows can know why I'm so enamored and have such a girl crush on you.
Well, you know, I grew up in Dallas, Texas. I live now in Austin, Texas, but I grew up in Dallas, Texas, the youngest of four children at the time, and then my parents decided for some crazy reason to have a kid when I was 10 years old. I finally got over that after years of therapy. but I grew up in a great, you know, great family, gregarious family, entrepreneurial family that really inspired me to, you know, the kind of that army slogan of be all you can be, you know, try this, go do that, do whatever you want to do. And after I left college at the University of Texas, I started to understand that people would pay you to come and talk about your expertise. And that's really, even though I didn't call it dough for what you know back then, I learned at a very early age as a college athlete that what people were paying for in the marketplace was expertise. And so when Mia and I met, we were talking about the fact that we were, you know, she was doing hangouts a little bit more than I was. I was doing webinars a lot more than she was. And I said, you know, what people are tuning in for is the expertise. Either you're curating the expertise or you're, you know, straight to camera talking about your expertise. So that's kind of how I got to this place. But I will say for the last, I think in 2009, and Mia, you may not even know this, my brother died of a heart attack. Just suddenly, right? Yeah, just out of the blue died, 51 years old, of a heart attack. And I took some time off, and I actually coached this girl's basketball team. But during that time, the reason I didn't completely lose my mind was that I had the internet to get on and talk about my expertise. And the girl saved my life, but this whole notion of getting paid just to share and help people have bigger lives and bigger businesses by sharing your expertise really was born in 2009. And so that's what brings us to today.
You like to sneak stuff in on me, don't you? Because that's
yeah.
You're like, I can't show you.
You give me
these
sad music.
You're like, I can't show you everything. Hey, I'm going to just jump in with just a couple people. Debbie says it's been way too long since she's seen you. She's here and ready to take notes.
Hi, Debbie.
And then Nazim says, reading the intro on Fran confirmed two fellow badass girls in the house. So we've already got our street cred. Solidly identified right here. So we're just going to jump in. I'm ready to go. Yeah. We've got some bullet points that are great. I'm going to be over here if we've got some things that we need to pull up from the audience, but I'm ready to get the 411 from you, and then we'll both be kind of jumping in on it. So let's roll.
Excellent. So you guys have rolled with Mia before. If you rolled with me, if you're coming from my list and my community or the both of us, you know that we are, you know, by the seat of our pants for the most part with the plan. But it is one wild party here. So I start off this presentation by saying making dough for what you know is really pretty black and white. You know, I don't want to put up my screenshots, but really, it's pretty black and white. It's very straightforward. You can be boring or you can be a badass. That's basically the way I live my life. You can be boring or you can be a badass. So what this, you know, these few minutes are going to be about is helping you to kind of step into your pure badassery, whatever that is, and starting to monetize your hangouts and starting to make money for what you know. So we're going to jump right into what Mia has kind of primed you guys with, which are the four modules of making dough for what you know. The first one is kind of crystallizing your why. But before we even get to the why, crystallizing your who. I mean, who are you? A lot of times people will get on hangouts and they'll attempt to emulate what they've seen someone else do, or they'll try to imitate what they've seen other people do on their hangouts. And I leave going, you know, who was that? I don't think there's any doubt, you guys, and you can put it in the chat bar, you know who Mia is. You know what her persona is because, you know, she's bat crap crazy. You never know what she's going to say. That's who she is. So before we can start even talking about what your why is, we have to figure out, you know, who are you? And honestly, get to the point where you know exactly what that persona is, because you can't start to kind of craft what your brand is until you know who you are. Now, as you'll notice, I have on two different earrings. Mia, had you noticed that?
Not a bit.
Of course you did.
I was too busy putting on lip gloss and muting myself in the green room.
That's right. But I got to tell you guys a really funny story, and it's relevant to figuring out who you are on the air, okay? So I have on two different earrings. Many years ago, these friends of mine had gone on a small vacation. This couple had gone on a vacation, and they left me with their daughter. That was scary. They left me to kind of take care of their daughter. And their daughter wanted to wear, like, these polka dot pants and this striped shirt to school the next day. And so she said, this is my favorite shirt, these are my favorite pants, and this is what I want to wear. And so I let her wear. And so, you know, she was happy. She had the polka dot pants and a striped shirt. And I let her wear those because that was her. That mm-hmm. was uniquely her. And I wasn't going to allow the distractions of what people might think and what they might say, because that was that kid. Mm-hmm. Now, of course, when my friends got back, the wife was like, you did what? Well, you let my daughter
was it,
leave
this was
house.
It like picture day, too? They're like, what is that kid wearing? Actually, yeah. And I need to point out what's funny is that you said they left you with their daughter, which I love. That would be
right.
Me, too. I'm going to leave you
That's
with
right. Me. That's right. Well, the mom was like, what did you let her wear? What? And I was like, yeah, I let her wear the polka dot pants and the striped shirt because that's her identity. And the dad yeah. was like, he was chuckling, right? He was just like, you're going to get in trouble. But I was like, this is my opportunity to give you a lesson, parents, in personal identity and branding.
I love
that
it.
That is a great branding lesson because that kid wanted to be herself. And there's no reason. Sometimes we go out there and we go, well, we don't want to do this because, you know, what are people going to say? What are people going to do? If you're too crazy, Mia, people mm-hmm. are not going to want to watch your show, Fran. If you're wearing two different earrings or if you're too loud, people are not going to. That's who I am. Mm-hmm. What I did with that kid is who I am, but it was also who she was. And so the first part of this, before we start even talking about making dough for it to know and monetizing, is figure out who you are and be okay with who you are. I mean, right. You got to be okay with who you are because in a sea of millions of, eventually millions of hangouts, what you're going to have a difficult time doing is breaking through the noise. And Mia, you may be able to identify with this right now. I mean,
yeah.
there, when we first started doing hangouts, you know, I'm going to make up some numbers. There were, you know, two people doing them, three people doing them. Now there are 3,000 people doing them by the end of the month. So part of your challenge with doing this stuff is distinction in the marketplace. Mm-hmm. Are you going to be afraid to put on two different earrings? Are you going to be afraid to put on the striped pants and the polka dot shirt if that's truly who you are? So the first thing I want to say is know who you are. The marketplace needs to know who you are. And then the second thing is, you know, what is it, what's unique about what you're bringing to the marketplace? If I share some of the things I talk about on stages all over the world, I always say there are only three different ways to be different. Your message has to be different, the messenger has to be different, or the method is different. That's it. Those are the only three ways to be different.
Right.
You, the messenger, is different, your message is different, or the way you do things, your method is different. So.
Can I jump in here and ask a question or clarification? I think it's also
sure.
good. I know for myself when I started doing the hangouts, again, this was 8 months ago, but it was still, there weren't as many. This is definitely mm-hmm. the year. I have it on my banner on my other show. It's, you know, the year of the HOA, so a lot
yep.
of people are doing that. So I definitely suggest, too, of like this balance of doing your homework and seeing what's out there that's in your arena once you get a little more clarified. But then again, you got to just, and for me, I had to do it too because I was seeing that it was very male dominated. That was a show that we
yeah.
did on gender diversity. Remember the back in mm-hmm. February? Super male dominated. And so I had to just kind of push past that fear of being this goofy woman coming on Hangouts. It really felt that way compared to some of the other shows and just feel like the crickets chirping for a while. So I just wanted to throw that in there too. That's part of that.
And that's, yeah, without question, that's very important because it was a struggle for you just to be you. I mean, that's the whole thing. But what people don't understand is if you're going to be one person when you're off the air and a different person when you're on the air, that incongruency will be felt through the screen. Right? People will get the sense like, you know, who is this chick? Who is this dude? I mean, whatever. So the struggle is for everybody. It's for men and women. I mean, I have male mm-hmm. clients who are very uncomfortable being who they are and don't know who they are. And right. So when they get on camera, they're boring. When they get on camera, they're not very engaging. So this is a really important part, guys. I mean, I know a lot of people go, oh, we want, let's get to the money part. Let's get to the monetization part. But honestly, if you are unable to be true to who you are on air, and I say on air, whether it's through your computer or on television, you won't have longevity doing anything. So the first place, the first station is really crystallizing who, the what, and the why. Okay, so the who are you? I mean, really, who are you? You're a crazy chick who likes to talk about business? Are you a crazy dude who crystallizes tech? Who are you? What do you bring to the marketplace, and why are you doing it?
Yes.
People always talk about, you know, what's your why? You know, why are you doing this? Are you doing this because you are inspired by, you know, sharing your knowledge because you like being on camera? There's nothing wrong with that. I mean, there's no shame in just being a camera hog. I mean, if you just like being on camera like Mia, I mean, you...
I've gotten better at it, that's saying. You get more comfortable because then, like, this is my way of blogging. How's that?
Yeah.
Because I like doing video better than blogging. And I'm going to go out there on a limb and say, I have a feeling it's going to get to the point where people have seen mine and have said, oh my gosh, I need to be this way to get the message across. Yeah. And on the flip, if that's not your comfort level, it's going to come across super awkward. So I say, you know, embrace, you know, I always say I'm an outgoing introvert. But I've learned that this is a great medium for me. So embrace whatever that, you know, particular thing is, because you could be that dry, quiet person, and there's a lid for every pot. There's somebody out there that wants to see that style.
That's right. So let's hear what we're moving on to the next module. Anybody got any thoughts that they want to throw out before we move on to business models?
You know, a couple Tiara comments. We've got Cheryl Deuce. We've got Irene Brody. Love her. She says, I will probably die with a pen in my hand. love her. Nazim real quick says, TV versus Hangout Media, which do you prefer? Which is, we didn't really talk about that, Fran, but I mean, Fran comes from, you know, you're working with the Longhorns Network right now. You're the commentator for... you know how I am with sports. I always get football. I'm kidding. But for the Longhorn Network, for the Longhorns basketball team, correct?
That's correct. Play-by-play announcer, but that's okay. But yeah, we're going
to
actually...
Theater, but I think he's referring to me.
Yeah, exactly. We're going to get to TV. We're going to actually get to TV before it's all over. But I want to talk a little bit about your business model now, and it's a great segue from the why. Like, why are you doing this? And so I just kind of want to throw this out. Why did you start doing hangouts, Mia? Why did you start doing them?
Freedom. Absolutely freedom. I always joke about it. I was working at I had a radio show that was offered to me that was on an all-women's network, and I was driving 45 minutes each way to the radio station for literally only 15 minutes of airtime. It was filled in with the rest of it, and I could only interview women, and I literally had a moment of kind of the spirit moment of like, that's not your brand. And I had to turn down, you know, what seemed to be free radio, but yet I didn't have the freedom. And so then I was able to do these hangouts with and have my message, because my message is unisex, not just women.
Which is how a lot of people start doing hangouts. They do it because they want the freedom. They want to start, you know, teaching, getting their message out there, doing demos of their software, whatever. That's how most people start. In fact, I would venture to say probably 70% of the people that I know start doing hangouts because of what I just said.
Yes.
And so they don't always think about the business side, the potential business side of it, okay, for a lot of different reasons. So I'm going to talk about two business models, basically. And when I talk about business models, I just mean, you know, how you make money, the process by which you would potentially make money. But first I want to say, there are two things. If you don't nail down a business model for your hangouts, you're going to have two things. You're going to have unpredictable results, and you're going to have unpredictable income. That's just the reality of it. And that's for any business, online or offline. If you haven't really crystallized your business model, you're going to be all over the place in terms of what you're getting. One month you're going to make $500. The next month you might make $5,000. So what we really want to do is to make sure that you guys left today with at least the thought of, okay, how do I want to do this? Okay, so two things we're going to talk about. You can be the solo talk show host, and that's the person who literally gets in front of the camera or with their screenshots, or they share their slides on the screen, and all they do is teach and do their show with the effects. It's them all the way to the bank. That's it.
Right.
Now, the good thing about that is that you don't have to book, you don't have to book people. You never have to worry about guests. You never have to worry about whether they're going to show up. You never have to worry about any of those things that might fluctuate your ability to do a great show. The bad thing about that is that it's all you all the time, right?
Right.
It's like you, there's nothing but you. And thankfully, Google Hangouts has given us lots of little things to help us not be boring on the air, in case you might err on the side of being boring. You got sound effects, you got crowns and tiaras and things that you can put on your head. But it's difficult to be a one-woman or one-man show for a complete season of your show. That might be a real big challenge.
It is, and let me give an example of that is Craig Chamberlain. He was doing, he's not doing as many, but he has one show where it's just him for about an hour, and he's doing tech talk, and he's answering questions, but it is him carrying that. So there's, that's a lot of weight on your shoulders.
Yeah. Yeah, when I started doing my, my shows, I knew, first of all, I feel like personality-wise, I could carry the time, but why would you want to? I mean, seriously. So I started doing 15-minute shows. I felt like that was the sweet spot for me to do 15-minute shows, whether it was just me or whether it was me and a guest. And, you know, given how distracted we are when we're online, how many of you raise your hand? If you're online, you have 13 other windows open. You're probably surfing the net as you're watching me in right now. It's okay. So that's how it is. You got to realize that that's what you're up against when you do your hangouts. You're up against distractions. You're up against people looking at other things, listening to podcasts. So if you want to do a solo show, the good side of that is obviously it's just you. You never have to worry and wait on anyone else. The bad side is that it's just you. And so you've got to be confident in your content and your ability to carry a show. The other business model is the curating talk show host, which is kind of what Mia does as well. So she curates. She brings experts on. She brings other people on, does a combination of her own stuff, and then she'll bring some other people on to talk about different things. This is a great model. This is the Oprah Winfrey model. I mean, think about it. Oprah became a billionaire by curating content. She became a billionaire by sitting on a sofa and talking to other people. I mean, that's pretty much what she did. If you look at the other model that I talked about, that's what that's how Susie Orman is a multimillionaire. She looks at the camera like we're doing right now and talks about her expertise. Both are great ways to attempt to make money. You just got to figure out what, you know, what's the best fit for you.
Sure.
Mia, you have any thoughts from the trenches on that?
Well, and I think I also call it, I love it, curate. I love it just that I get to showcase. So I think for that particular model, it's because I'm so excitable that I get super excited. I had a conversation with a woman who's coming on my show on Friday who hasn't been on Hangouts that much, and I know what she's going to say about book publishing is going to fire people up. And so then that for me is my medium of transporting the information is I don't have to know all of it.
Yeah.
I have to know about it and about them, but what I get to do is say is I get to sew a story together with people. So it's not there. That's a different type of work. They're
and
both
that's great. I mean, yeah, that's great because I think sometimes what stops a lot of people from doing this is they think they have to know everything, right?
Yes.
You think you have to know everything.
You really
and you don't have to know everything.
Right, and that's, I mean, a good example of it is Friday. It's all about book publishing, and I've been very clear with my guests of, like, I know how to read. And that's it. Yeah, but that's why you bring people on.
Right, right. So if you're passionate about a topic, you know, if you're excited about a topic, if you're curious about a topic, I mean, how cool would it be to do a hangout just on stuff you're curious about? Call it the Curious Hangout. You know, today I was curious about this, so I got this person on. I mean, think about it. That would be a really fun show to do. Never know what you're going to get.
That's how I started out. I was basically, I just talked to people. Mine was a very short format. I turned it into the more of the panel thing, but it was one-on-one, and it was literally, I interviewed people from my high school. One is our town mayor. Just people I thought were doing cool stuff, but I didn't call it that, and I love that, so.
So stay tuned for that, exactly.
Yeah, I may be getting back to that for a minute. But that's a great point, though, Fran. Yes.
That would be a fun show. So now we segue to Lights, Camera, the next module, Lights, Camera, Hangouts. And this is a module that I'm really excited about because, you know, in my quick introduction, I knew we were going to get into it later in the show. You know, what I've done for the last 20 plus years is I've made my living, part of my living, as a television personality. So I was a basketball player at the University of Texas, went right into sportscasting with ESPN, and have done it with Lifetime. I've hosted my own show on HGTV. Some of you may remember that from a few years ago called Home Rules. You can see it on HGTV.com. You can see all the episodes there right now. So television has been my thing. And so what you have to learn when you're on television is that, you know, the camera picks up everything. It picks up your nervousness. It picks up your twitches. It picks up your idiosyncrasies. It picks up everything. And people are so nervous about being on camera. And so when you're doing your HOA, your hangout, you're literally on camera. And you're literally on the air. And so I know that stops a lot of people from actually doing it because they think, I have a face for radio, or what if I mess up? Right. You know, what if I do this or whatever? And all of that is completely okay. I will tell you, when I started in television, I was nervous as hell. I can't even think of an analogy of how nervous I was, because you think about it, you're standing there, there's this camera there, there's this red light, there's this producer saying, in 3, 2, and you're like, oh my God! Yeah,
that just makes my heart pound. Like, I'm in front of a camera right now, but yeah, that whole, like, right, oh my goodness.
Yes, it's very nerve-wracking, but I have to tell you, and I'm going to give you the same advice that a CBS producer gave me, you know, 15 years ago. Mm-hmm. He said, after a show, we had just done a game, I'd just done a WNBA game, and he came up and he said, can I talk to you for a second? I said, sure. He said, great game, you know, love you on the air, whatever. He says, just give it a little piece of advice. I said, sure. He says, if you would be the person you are when you're hanging out by the pool after the game, if you would be that girl, that chick, on the air, you have no limits.
Wow, and I bet that was so eye-opening for you.
That really was. That was amazing, because what you guys are doing, what we all do, is you see people who do what you want to do, and you think, okay, I'll just do it like they do it. But again, it goes back to module 1, you can't be somebody else. You have to be, you know, for lack of a different cliche, you have to be authentically you. And so what Craig was saying was, be crazy, be outgoing, be opinionated, be the chick by the pool after the game.
Right.
And so that's what I did. And it completely created separation in the marketplace. You know, you may have seen some of my ads on Facebook where I talk about being the $50 million woman. I've gotten over $50 million in free television publicity just by being me. I mean, that's the beauty of it. I didn't go to any school to do anything. No, I didn't have any classes. I just had the confidence to be bad at something. I want you to hear that. I was courageous enough to be bad at it because I figured eventually I would get good at it. Did you gonna say something, Mia?
They can't see me on the film strip, but I mean, that's what's so great. I just want to encourage everyone. There is a tremendous amount of courage that goes into making that decision, but you do just go, and that's what you did too, because you think about it. When I started, it felt, and I'm going back to the male dominated, but there's a point to that, and then yours was as well. So you're thinking, and this can go across the board, you're thinking you have to be a certain way, but if you can jump and do that and just kind of switch that out, and now you guys see why I wanted to partner with Fran on this show, is because these are so many of the things that I preach as well. I mean, you definitely don't have to have it perfect. That's the great thing, because you can build into these shows what your style is. I mean, from the beginning, I just decided I'm going to really celebrate, you guys hear me say it all the time, the hot mess of it. And that way, if Bob jumps onto the computer, you know, it's an anticipation. It was a gradual thing. I'm not saying I had that shtick down right off the bat. The TR was just accidental. It kept showing up every time I got on. The Mickey Mouse hands, that one's kind of new, but I'm really enjoying that people may think, you know, and I've had some criticism for the TR, and I just go, okay, then maybe my show's not for you because it's not going anywhere.
Right.
That's okay.
Exactly. So
that was what I had. Listen,
that's great. I love that you inserted that, because it really is about doing the best show you can do. And the best show that you can do is going to be the best you. And I don't want to gloss over this or go really fast, because this is the coup de grace. I mean, this is the thing that makes your hangout really good, is it's you. People tune in to see you. And so if you can just have the courage to be bad at it, perhaps. Some of you may be great at it.
Yes.
You know, but I'm only speaking from experience. I've been in television for 20 years, and I, you know, thank God I'm still in television. You got to have the courage to be bad at something to eventually get good at it. And
okay,
so I still have a favor
at the end. We don't have to do it now, but I do want to have you maybe tell like one or two of your just crazy moments. We all love it. We all love, okay, what happens?
You know, you're going to laugh at my pain?
A little bit.
Okay.
Is it pantyhose tucked, you know, skirt tucked?
Yeah, I will do that.
We definitely need that. So thank you.
I will do that. In the meantime,
the story that Fran told you guys, if you're going to take, I just, that really nails it. The thing where he said, you need to be that girl, that woman.
Yeah.
Cool. That's right. A great takeaway.
That's it. That says everything. And, mm-hmm. you know, turning on the computer and just having the courage to just do you and be you is the best advice I can give you, which is the hardest advice for most people, because we live in a world that's conditioned us to be like everybody else. We live in a world that, you know, wants to send you emails about your TR, or we live in a world with people who have some kind of criticism for everything you do. If you cannot be invested in the criticism that people will have of you, you'll do well. If you're going to be bothered consistently and invested in the criticism that you will get from people, you're not going to be, you're not cut out for this. Don't do this. Don't ever turn on your computer. Don't ever do a hangout. Because you're broadcasting
of stories of that. So
that's right. We're broadcasting to the world, and people are going to, they're going to have their opinion about it. So lights, camera, hangout. I mean, you don't need any fancy thing. I could do a whole course about, okay, well, you need to get the XQZA light. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's a whole different thing. And I don't want to put those barriers in your way when all you need to do is turn on your camera and do what you do. So
yes. And let's face it, Fran, that could change in 2 days. We have to acknowledge that this is an ever-changing, still beta program. Yeah. So you really have to get a little bit relaxed on that as well. I mean, you don't want to have working on, you know, in a coffee shop where it's loud and you're on, you know, this public Wi-Fi. You definitely don't want to do that. You want to do as well as you can and test it out. Don't go spend a bunch right off the bat. And because again, things
can change
anytime.
Things could change. You could change your mind. You could change your format. Yeah. But if we're going to talk about, you know, maybe formats of your shows, mm-hmm. I would encourage you to start small. Do a 5-minute show once a week. Do a 10-minute show twice a week, whatever feels right for you, whatever you know you're going to do, because you're building up an audience. And trust me, when people start seeing your content, they're looking for you. So they're, okay, so Fran does a show every Monday at this time. And, you know, then they tune in. It's like television. They tune in and you're not there. Okay, they move on to the next person. So you want to make sure that you are making the commitment you can make. Even you may get excited after you're off with me and Mia today, don't go out there and decide you're going to do a 5-day show. If you're not going to do a 5-day show, you know,
right.
Do what you can do. That's the most important thing. Turn on your computer and do what you can do. I will give you a couple of technical things. You know, try to get a good mic. Like I'm using just one of my iPhone's mics. That's good. Your computer mic. Do use the best equipment that you have right now. Until you're committed, in my opinion, I would not go out and spend money. Some
and
people
let
may tell
something
you
on that.
But I
did not buy this until 4 months ago. And that was when I decided that I was going to also be podcasting things. So
that's right.
So
yeah,
I agree. Thank you for that.
So don't go out and spend any money unless you know you're going to do it. Doing a great show is not about your microphone. Oh, here it is. Doing a great show, candidly, is not about your microphone. It's not about your lights. It's about your content. It's about the connection that people have to your content. It's about the promise of your brand. So if people are tuning into your show because they know they're going to get fired up on Monday morning, you're going to send them off, that's what they're tuning into. They will not remember your background. They will not remember your blue mic. They just won't. So
I'm
before
just
you
waiting
get
to see
off,
how many people type in "preach it, sister." That's worth this. The show that I'm telling you, that's going
to
be worth
it. I just want you to know that. I mean, because you see people doing things and you get wowed by the production value of people you may admire, and you're thinking, well, yes, good Bob. If I got to go get a snazzy white background and I got to get this, then there's no way. So now you're not doing it. So hear us.
Mm-hmm.
Turn your computer on and do you. That's how you start your hand.
That's right, because everything that I've got going on, this has all been gradual for me, and I still need
That's
to get
right.
some new lights, and everybody knows I had a question, I had a problem, I was calling it I had a problem with Comcast, and I was calling it the C word this week, and I think it looks a little bit better, but I mean, you're just, it takes a while to get that. So, but right. I agree with you, because if you start getting really caught up in that, you're going to lose that authenticity, that genuine message. That was authenticity for you, Mark Seidel, because he loves that word. It's so overused, but it's true. It's there for a reason. You're going to lose that girl by the pool. Let's call it that. The girl.
That's right. And you're going to lose your momentum. You're going to lose your momentum. You're thinking, okay, well, I can't start till next week because that's when my mic is coming in. No, fire up your computer and go. And guys, I still have tapes from my very first year in television. I'm having them digitized and put on DVDs. I will never let go of that, because you want to see your growth. You want to see the first time you turned on your computer and looked at yourself and there you were up until you're done doing it. So for me, as Mia said, it's about that gradual evolution of who you are on the air. And that's what it's been about for me in television. I'm still getting better at things. I'm still getting less self-conscious about things, and that's just a part of it. But again, it goes back, absolutely. And now I laugh a lot more at myself. Like, I'll say some things on the air, and after I'm doing it, I will hit the cough button, because when you're on live television, there's a button that you press if you want to cough or curse. And so I hit the
curse.
Yours would be cursing. I hit the button, and I go, "What the heck did I just say?" And then I just laugh at myself, because you're never going to be perfect on the air, and you just have to get over the level of exposure that you have when you're on the air. And of course, when I say on the air, I mean being on the computer as well.
Yeah.
But I just want to reiterate something real quickly. Again, guys, if you can jot down or lock in your head, it's about the promise of your brand. That's what your hangout is about. It's about the promise of your show, the experience that people are going to have when they get there, and the promise of your content. That's it. It's not about anything else. It's never forget about why people tune in to see you. And the best way to find out, honestly, is to ask them. How about that? Not to just assume, hey, I know they're coming in because I'm a genius. No, they may be coming in because you really set their week off right. Or they may be coming in because you give a really good tip that helps them get through their day or their week or whatever it is. Just know the promise of your brand and your product and your experience. And you do that by asking the folks who show up. So any quick questions from folks as we're continue. I'm going to grab some water.
I'll tell you who needs this, our girl, Kristen. She's, Kristen, you got a message. She's saying she's, how long is it going to be bad at it? And now I also think that that's going to be something where, one of my tips that I use, I tell a lot of people to get what I call your board of directors. And that's going to be 4 or 5 people that are always going to watch your shows, or 2 or 3. And they're always, I have a couple of people that I always get to tag in after my show and be like, and they're like, oh, this was great, and give me the feedback. So you definitely need that so you can, stay, you can stay fresh and, always looking good, but then also to temper it, to be like, dude, nobody noticed. Do you know what I mean? That's what your personal board of directors does as well. So Kristen,
and
that's relative.
Yeah, Kristen, I'm glad you asked that question. Here's what I want to say to all of us about that, and this is going to step on some toes, and I'm glad about it. You want to make sure that when you're getting feedback from people, and even when you're giving feedback, you need to know whether that feedback is on your side of the street or if it's good feedback, meaning is this your stuff coming out? And so, for instance, let's say, Mia, my thing was, if I'm the person who is very self-conscious and who would never send a kid out of the house with polka dot pants and a striped shirt, then I would have a problem with your tiara, because the person who's very self-conscious. I'm the person who's very invested in what other people are thinking. Get it? I need some nods. People need to understand that when people give you feedback, what people have to say about you is about them, period. It's about them.
When there's always a balance. What you think of me is none of my business. I love that one. No, that's why you do get that board of directors. And I always go to get a little spiritual. I always go back to the 4 agreements as well. If you're going to be doing this, don't take things personally. Always do your best. I'm blanking on the other 2 because that's what I needed to know, was just those 2 right now. But those are really good. Don't make assumptions. You assume that somebody means this. So always take it certainly with a grain of salt.
Yeah, absolutely. And just that goes back to just surrounding yourself with the right people. like when I get feedback from people, I'm never wondering if there's an agenda behind it because I have the right people in my life. I know that they're thinking about me, and yes. You know, hey, and they always say, you know, maybe it's just me. I love it when my friends go, you know what, it could be my stuff, but when this happened, blah 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 blah, and I'm like, I love that. Or people will say, hey, just so you know, your mic went out. You want the technical stuff, you want to make sure you fix. The personal stuff, you need to sometimes make sure that you, like I said, have the right people in your life who are not giving you feedback because they have some sick and demented agenda to tear you down.
Yes, that's right. And you have to understand that you're always going to be in a bit of a vulnerable place. So it's even more important because you could kind of, you know, fall for it if somebody's, gosh, has this really strong opinion and you there is a bit of vulnerability. And then the other quick advice I'll give too is, and when you said that you have all the tapes of everything, I've been very consistent, even more so in the last couple months, of watching my show each time. One, because I miss so much. Then I'm like, oh, I mean, I did that. Oh my gosh, when you were on one of my shows, and I was just like typing it in because I'm like, oh, I missed that. I was so busy, weaving the story, and then I missed. Yes. I call my little bon mots, and so it's on a twofold thing. It's one that I'll pick up like, oh gosh, I maybe need to stop doing this or tweak or adjust this, and so I'm always constantly in line with what kind of message or what kind of image I want to put out there. Because I've watched it, I know some people find that to be painful, but I really would suggest it. I do it for two reasons. One, you know, to take it in and for that. And then the third reason would be I use it for time stamping and then for blog posting. So I kind of just make it, you know, this soak it in experience. So always factor in some time to go back and watch your show.
I love this module because it gets to the stuff that makes us uncomfortable. It gets to the stuff that makes us realize our vulnerability and our humanity. And that's good stuff for me. I mean, that's the stuff that makes you a really good host. The fact that you can, like Kristen can say, how long is it, how long should you be bad? And the reality is, Kristen, you should always be fixing something in your show, getting better at something. But it's people's kind of their fear of being bad and exposed that stops them from doing this kind of stuff. Think about it. I mean, like, there is a place to hide potentially on the internet. When you go on television, you know, millions of people see you. It's a trip. And then a producer, after every show, a producer comes and say, oh, come here, I have a little feedback for you. So you get used to the feedback, and you get feedback is a gift. Doesn't matter what it is. Feedback is a gift. So, Kristen, my thing is look at your shows, you know, check them out, ask someone, as Mia said, hey, take a look at my show, 5 or 10 minutes of my show, let me know what you think about it. And start to get the regularity, get in the model, the mindset of feedback is a part of the process. You go out there, you do it, you give, and then feedback is a part of the process. So I know we talked about that.
Yeah, and be kind to yourself, right? When you're doing it, you gotta
be gentle.
Yes, be gentle.
Yeah, be gentle to yourself. And now I'm asking you to be gentle to yourself when some of us have had lives where we've been so hard on ourselves. And now I'm gonna put you on camera and put you on video and tell you to be gentle with yourself. So I will tell you that it is, and being able to laugh at myself and laugh at my mistakes and laugh at my goof-ups and laugh at words that I make up is all a part of the process, but it's also a part of the genius that is you. It's also a part of the whole package, and you just have to take all of that in. So you ready to move on to the final one, the monetization, Mia?
We are, and I can't wait for you to see the comments, though. It's just more of a Fran Harris cheering section, which is pretty fun. just one quick one. This is hi, and I had a wonderful conversation with Crystal this week. You just made my awesome women's circle. I appreciate your confidence, clarity, and charisma. Thank you for being you. So that, you know, boom. And by the way, she's in Austin, so.
Oh, wow. Cool. Awesome. Yeah. Thank you so much for that. I appreciate that.
Yes, absolutely.
I love this.
That's staying true to purpose is when your message is coming across. So again, now you see why I was awesome. Like, oh, yeah, let's do this show together.
I love this. I love this. And I love you too, Mia. Have I told you that today?
Not lately, because I muted myself and we had to make fun of me. Talk about laughing at yourself. I was all giving her advice like, no, I love you. And I'm like, yeah, that was me.
Yeah, you can tell that story at the end. All right, so we're gonna move on to the fourth module, which I know a lot of you got on the Hangout to talk about this. Do not sleep on the first three modules. They are critical.
That's
to
right.
You being really great at this stuff. But the last one that people
need to work. About, this part won't work if you haven't gotten this thing.
Thank you, sister. That is exactly it. If you don't fix the – people always want to get to the outer game. If you don't work on your inner game, the outer game is never going to be as big as it can be. Trust me, from experience, I know that to be true. And it's not just true for me, by the way. So three monetization ideas that I bet you never even thought about. In one of the ads that we put online, I said, you know, you're going to come to this hangout with me and Mia, and you're going to get some unrehashed business ideas to grow your brand. And I guarantee you haven't thought about these or heard these from very many people. So the first one, I'm going to give you three of those, all right, if you want to take some notes. The first one is product placement in your hangouts. Product placement in your hangouts. So brand integration.
I'm Instagramming you.
Exactly. So Mia, right, look at the products that she is actually integrating into her show right now. I don't know, what kind of phone is that? Is that a Galaxy?
This is, I call it my phablet. It's a giant note. A phablet for a phone and a tablet. Yes, ma'am.
So Mia just integrated that brand into her Hangout on cue. We didn't plan that. She literally just did that. But you can do those kinds of things in your Hangout, and now you don't really have commercials. You have brand integration. A good example of this, of course, is like American Idol when they have the big oversized Coca-Cola cup sitting there on their table, okay? The Mickey Mouse or whatever. Integrate brands into your show. Now, when you start out, sponsors, just like when you get sponsorships, they may not want to, you know, give you a whole lot of money to do that until you grow your following. But how cool would it be if you had a phone, you know, a phone integrated in your thing, or a headset if you wanted to use Beats or some other thing in your headset, a beverage that you use, different things like that you can do that are very inobtrusive that you can put into your show and literally surround yourself with thousands of dollars of brands that you just integrated into your show without ever taking a commercial break.
Right. Love that. Yeah. And I think that's what people are looking for now, too. I mean, there's so much kind of pushback and fuss about advertising and so forth. So it's more about, you know, as Guy Kawasaki calls it, being the brand, you know, evangelist. I mean, we
that's
are
right.
excited about things. Why not just incorporate it in that manner?
Right. So start thinking about the things that you would naturally have in your environment when you're doing your hangout. I mean, for most of us, it's going to be water. And you know, Ozarka ain't giving me no money, girlfriend, right now. I'm going to turn this thing around. I'm going to show the side of Ozarka. But you know, so think of the things you might have on your show. You would have water. You would probably have your phone. You would have your microphone. Why not call the Blue Yeti people, or call, you know, some phone company, or call a water, or brand this, quite frankly, with your own brand.
Yes.
You can do lots of different things that you can do without doing going the commercial route, which, by the way, I have nothing against commercials. I'm just giving you some things that haven't been rehashed before that you can think about that would be easy to integrate.
Easy
exactly.
to integrate. That's right. You can do it today.
Exactly. So the first one is to get some brand integration into your Hangouts, and then the second one is to repackage your Hangout and then syndicate it on YouTube. Now, a lot of people do Hangouts, and they will just do the Hangouts, and then boom, 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 that's it. They never do anything else with it. But if you repackage your Hangout, let's say Mia had a Hangout where they were talking about publishing, and then like you're going to do on Friday, and let's say I have a 30-second interstitial, which is what we call them in television. They're like these branded vignettes that I have on how to get a six-figure advance from a New York publisher. So in that, I might come in and give a 30-minute tip on how to write your book proposal. Well, you would have to download your YouTube video, edit my interstitial in your show, but think of how many of those that might be relevant and complementary to the show that you did that you can put in there and then put on YouTube. And now SEO and search engine optimization, you know, put it together in terms of your tags and that kind of stuff, and now you have a show that's making you money forever.
Gotcha.
Is that clear, Mia? Did I
No.
Well,
no, that's really big. So yeah, let me give it. So an example, yes. So let's say, so I would back that up. So I would take because I love that idea too. Because we already have it that we've got the YouTube, so we've got those views. But I think we are kind of leaving a lot on the table. One, we should be downloading all of ours and backing them up.
Yeah.
You know what's going to happen. So tip for HOA hosts, that's in my process map. as soon as it's done, to download that MP4 and have it sitting somewhere completely separate. Mm-hmm. But you're saying then to download that, and yeah, I think we are missing that, of like kind of making that into, is it more like sound bites or vignettes, or you're saying you're integrating other people's things? Like I would integrate yours into it.
Yeah, so a couple of things you can do. You can download your video. We're going to get to, actually my last one is turning your HOA into a podcast. But you download your video, you download this show, and you figure out the segments of our show that might be that maybe you had another expert who has a 30-second tip that might fit into what we're doing. So
okay.
You literally just edit those segments into an existing show, upload them back to YouTube. Now it's a different show, because it has those vignettes in it. It has those branded interstitials in it that, by the way, people paid you to be in.
That's
so,
yeah, absolutely. And
you see what I'm saying?
I do, and we have I know Scott Scowcroft, he's not in the audience, but he does a lot of that too. And I think, you know, we have a version of that with doing the time stamping so that people can jump to it. So I'm thinking too, having that time stamping is a great way to go through your content and say,
absolutely,
I'm gonna pull out these little sound bites. It's definitely something I think that's part of that rebranding or repurposing, I should say, of using it. So good one, I like it.
That's right, yep. And then the third one, of course, is So the third one is taking your HOAs and, of course, just extracting the audio and uploading them to iTunes. I mean, that to me, as much as I hate the phrase no-brainer, it really, a lot of people are not doing that. You just extract the audio from it. There are lots of, by the way, guys, there's a tool online called YouTube2mp3.org. That allows you to put the links of your YouTube videos and download it. It converts into an MP3 in 5 seconds. So that's YouTube2mp3.org. And if you want to jot that down, so you can do
that. Honestly, post that link, you guys.
Yeah, you can do that for any YouTube video, by the way. But if you're thinking, oh shoot, I got to do all these extra steps, no, really. Once you do your Hangout, you get your YouTube link. You just upload it to this site online, and it spits out an MP3. Now you have an MP3 to upload to iTunes to do your podcast. Now it's a podcast. So, and of course, that's a whole separate area of potential sponsors, potential branded interstitials, potential part. I mean, all different kinds of things that you can do in that scenario. So, three things more than anything, guys, is to, you know, make sure you get your shows that you're, when you're doing your shows, that you're getting some product placement in there. The second thing is repackaging them and syndicating them on YouTube, and then the third one is repurposing them and creating some additional method, what do you call them, modalities of them, so that you now have a podcast, video or audio podcast on iTunes.
And that's just an even better way to really make that, for the dough for what you know, making it exponential. So you're not, I mean, you're doing extra work, but you're it's almost like adding more ingredients, you're making a bigger version of it, right? I mean,
right.
You've got the same main thing, but you're adding to it and taking and blowing it up, which, you know, we all love that. We talk about that of like, you know, passive income or things like that. Like this is, if you've got that content, and it's speaking to me because these are things I have on my list to do, right? But I've done those first three steps. So now I'm at that point. I have enough content, and it's been great. You know, I've had to get strategic in the way that I do shows as well now, too. I mean, I do bumpers at my 30-minute mark and things like that. So these are things you can get into. But again, this can be in the same way of, you know, I'm kind of in that, you know, what am I waiting for, thinking it's going to be perfect. So this is a little kick in my patoot.
The fourth, I'll give you a bonus one, and everybody should be doing this. The fourth one is something I've done, you know, for years, and that's before. Bonuses are great. Our webinars. Think about this, guys. After Mia and I do this Hangout, I'm going to cajole her to send me the link to this, because now I'm going to make this an automated webinar. So we've done the show. We put this into an automated webinar system. We drive traffic to it. Hey, how would you like to learn, you know, how to monetize your Hangouts on air or whatever? Drive people to it, and then you can either sell your products or get them into your, you know, as subscribers on your newsletter or whatever. But the content, the hard part, if it's even hard, is what we're doing right now. Once you do the show, you're unlimited in terms of what you can do with that. If you're not doing webinars, and specifically automated webinars, because I don't want to be tied to my desk. My schedule is too sporadic. to be at a certain place at a certain time. I mean, I could, it's crazy. And I'll tell you guys this real quick story. A few years ago, I was speaking at a conference in London. And after I left London, I played basketball, played professional basketball in Italy and Switzerland. So after I left London, I was going to go to Italy and Switzerland to visit my friends and family. And so I go over on a Tuesday. I lose my voice on the way, like that day. I mean, literally had no voice. This was my first experience with laryngitis. You know how traumatic that was for a talker. I had no voice. And so that night, I'm coughing my brains out. My friends are like, this is great. You know, Francesca's upstairs. We're never going to see. I mean, I was out. Medicine, right. I was doped up. And I checked my phone and my PayPal account. I had $10,000 in my PayPal account from an automated webinar. From an automated webinar. So now you're going, a speaker can't talk. So literally, in the old days, if a speaker couldn't talk, a speaker couldn't make money. Today, guys, there's no reason for you not to take the content that you have, your HOAs, put them in an automated webinar system, and now it's just a matter of sending traffic to them, whether it's, you know, two people a day. I mean, how many of you, I want them to raise their hand, how many of you guys would not like to see $500 on today that you had nothing to do with, that literally was automatic? I mean, who does not want that?
Especially when you have no voice and haven't even talked that day. And then you got for talking that.
That's right. So the bonus one is a huge one, is doing HOAs, immediately putting them in an automated webinar system, and that is the ultimate automatic monetization, guys. It is ridiculous. It is almost scary. It really is. There are some mornings I look around, I go, is this legal? I mean, seriously, I go, this is crazy. But we're online all the time looking for information. You know, how do you do this? And I go, watch a webinar. I go, how do you do this? I go, watch a webinar. I'm buying a product. So why don't you have your own automated webinar system set up? I mean, I can talk about that all day.
You know, and I'm going to bring up Scott's comment because he's here in the audience. If you don't repurpose your HOA, hey, Iggs, he's awesome, then you're leaving money on the table. And that's really what this is about. And again, the ease of like taking and growing exponentially your one effort and doing the work on it. And listen, for everybody who's you know, in this, let's hear your comments too about, you know, Nazim saying love the podcast tip. You know, Scott works in that too. There's some people that work in this too that could help us out and offer services. So let's hear that too, because, you know, I love the collaborative effort. There's stuff I don't want to do. It's not
right,
that high.
Exactly.
My time, right? Like, this is what I do. And so then having a team, you know, around me of people that can help me do that as well, because there's plenty out there. But those are awesome. And again, I'm going to reiterate, if you haven't gone for those first three steps, then this fourth part about it, you know, 0 + 0 is what, right? Because it's not really going to have something that people would necessarily hear. But if you built that up over time and have the content or built up that message and have found the audience, then boom, you're solid.
Right, and the great thing is that you don't have to do all four of these. You can do one of these. Just do one. If your thing is only going to be automated webinars, good for you. If your thing is only going to be podcasts and you can monetize that, good for you.
Yeah.
I mean, good point. This is all there for you.
We'd all get a little, as I like to say, the Martian squeezy head. You've seen this, you know? I'm like, overwhelmed. I actually did that one too. And you don't want to get overwhelmed.
Scary.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, you don't.
Yeah, that's the the little face staring at you. What do you think? So can we drill down and give a couple of quick tips for everybody, like just to start? Just throw it out there. Of like, I know we've given all that, but what would be your number one tip you want people to start doing today?
I don't give tips. I'm not giving them any more tips. I'm giving them a directive. Giving them a directive tonight.
Set you up,
turn
girlfriend.
On your computer and do a 5-minute hangout on topic. Because you need to jump off the cliff. Sometimes you need to stand on the side of the ocean, on the side of the pool, hold your nose, pray, and jump. That's what you need to do. You don't need to prepare anymore. You don't need to talk to me or Mia. You don't need to call me. You don't need to text me. You need to stand on the side of that cliff and jump. So tonight, 5 minutes, turn on, get up, you know, figure out, mess up, get whatever, 5 minutes, look at that camera and do a hangout. Call a girlfriend or a boyfriend and say, hey, jump on this thing for me so I know that there's, you know, another person on there. I can work out some stuff. Do it. 5 minutes. That's the tip. Go do it.
I love it. And I'm going to throw it out there, too. If you've really got a pair, you can post the link here on this.
Yes! Oh, that is so good. Wait, listen. No. Let me me tell you something, y'all. What Mia just said is it posted on there. I promise you, I will look at it and give you some feedback. I promise you.
Now that is worth it. Yeah, we'll get in there and we'll be kind. Don't worry. But, I've watched my old ones too and been like, oh dear Lord.
Yep.
No, it's all good. It's awesome.
The first one is the hardest one. Without question. But if you get off here and just literally, in fact, if you get off here and just go do it, that's probably the best thing because you don't have a whole lot of time to stew on it. But before the clock strikes midnight tonight, get on your computer and just do one. You will feel the exhilaration of having done it, and that's what's going to be amazing. And Mia and I are going to give you some feedback. Post it, but it has to be posted publicly.
Yes, yeah, it does. We need to all be able to see it. Absolutely. I'm going to give you a couple more comments because we have Larry Finelli in the audience. He's down in Trinidad. He would love to add cooking shows to web. This is really resonating for a lot of people, for sure, because Nazim's also saying no idea about the importance of webinars. So this is really good because this is stuff that's available to us. It felt like it was a very kind of corporate or larger business thing. And it's not anymore. And think about how much it's helping people. What you've got to say, that's the lid for every pot, I'm telling you. So,
when we were talking earlier about when I was saying you need to know who you are, what you're doing, and why you're doing it, you know, I get such an amazing adrenaline rush when I help people do something they didn't think they could do. I know as an athlete what it's been like for me to be terrible. A lot of people don't know. First of all, I played in the WNBA, and they played on the Houston Comets' first WNBA championship team, and most people go, oh, wow. But a lot of people don't know that when I started playing basketball, my high school coach didn't think I was going to make it. And I don't tell you that to feel sorry. I mean, I just tell you that because there's a journey you take with whatever you do to become great at it. And most people suck at the beginning. But most people don't have the courage to suck. They don't have the courage to be bad at it, to ultimately get good at it. And what me and I are saying to you is go ahead and suck. I mean, go ahead and get it out of the way.
Oh, we got, listen to this one, the Badass Girls HOA Dish Reality Show. And that would be our closing line. You know what? Go ahead and suck.
That's right. Go ahead. I like that. That's quotable right there. Go ahead and suck. Yes. And and you'll eventually get good at it.
It's so true. It's so true. So we are almost at the top of the hour. We've had a consistent number of viewers, some great comments and questions. And you guys, as we finish, Fran's got some closing thoughts for you. And then as we finish, though, we really are, she's going to go back and comment in this event, too. So we're not leaving you.
Yes.
It's going to be good. But take it away, and then we're going to close up.
Yeah, so I know there's a percentage of you guys that want to go deeper and wider, so whenever I do my hangouts, I like to give lots of content, but I also know that there are people out there who are ready to really do this. So what I created is something called Lights, Camera, Hangouts. Mm-hmm. It's a four-week live masterclass with me. That means it's not you getting 65 videos. It's you in a live environment hangout like this with me for 4 weeks. The first module is really an extension of what we talked about today, where I work with you on crystallizing who you are in the marketplace, why you're doing what you're doing, and what you want to offer. A lot of people want to do this, but they don't have a clue about those three W's. They're like, you know, I don't know who I am. I'm 35 or 45, but I still don't know who I am. So I'm literally going to walk you from beginner, from Suckville, basically, to figuring out who you are in the marketplace. And honestly, we're not going to wait until you know everything about yourself or why you're doing it to start. So the first module is really about defining, you know, your brand persona, your HOA persona. The second week, and these are all live, by the way, the second week is about fine-tuning your expertise, what it is that you're going to be offering, and what your business model is. And this is the part when I've worked with folks who have been my personal clients. This week has been, you know, it's been one of those major aha moments because most creatives, I'm creative and business, most creatives don't know anything about business models. They don't know about, you know, how do I take just looking in the camera and turn that into a business, whether it's an extra $500 a month or whether it's an extra $50,000 a month. How do I do that? I've done all that, and I'm going to show you guys how to do that in week two. It's really about fine-tuning your specific business model. And they're really, I only talked about two today. There really are five or six of them. And so this gives you the opportunity to work with me in a group situation where you figure out what the best thing is. It's not me putting you in my business model or Mia's business model. It's you kind of taking the journey and figuring out where you need to go. Week three, is all about being on camera. Week three is all about not being shticky. It's about being you. So we develop your on-camera persona. Literally, I take you through what my broadcasting coach did with me, quite frankly, at the beginning of my career. Some of the craziest things, like putting corks between my teeth so that I would enunciate better. I mean, just it's some amazing stuff that you learn that just kind of makes you better on camera. Where do you look when you're on your computer? What's the difference between looking up here and looking down there? Those kinds of things. You know, how do you interact with guests that you have on your show? So week three is lights, camera, hangout, where it's all about figuring out who your on-air persona is. Week four, and again, guys, this is all live. This is not, again, 65 videos for you to watch. This is you in an interactive situation with me, and you get to bounce back and ask questions and get feedback from me. The final week is monetization. Really, it's about ways to cash in and cash out with hangouts and webinars. So I'm going to show you everything that I'm doing with hangouts, and I'm going to show you, you know, my 7+ years of doing webinars and how the automation, you know, process is unbelievable, and how you can do that with simple, you know, $37 software. This doesn't have to cost you a whole lot of money. That's then I'm also going to give you all. Isn't that cool? Yeah.
Very.
I'm also going to give you all my templates, all my resources, who I use to do my, you know, designs, who I use to do my automatic webinars, those kinds of things. You're going to get all of those. And then I'm also going to throw in 6 months of monthly Monday office hours. So even though you're going to be working with me for 4 weeks straight on this with this masterclass, every Monday, every first Monday of the month, you also get to come in for office hours. If you have something that's bugging you or that's not working in your building your HOA business, you get to come into my office and ask me about all of that. Now, I didn't go through the individual value of all of these because I think you guys can start to feel and build based on what me and I share. You know, we're talking about tens of thousands of dollars in terms of fast-tracking you to where you want to go.
Right.
And I'm going to do this with you guys for $497, for only $497. So if this resonates with those of you who are ready to do this, you can go to lightscamerahangout.com, literally, lightscamerahangouts.com. That special offer, and Mia will put it in, that special offer will be available until Friday, okay? LightsCameraHangout.com. And that is only for these Hangout folks, and it will be up until midnight on Friday. And guys, I mean, my favorite saying is a Chinese proverb that says, to know the road ahead, ask those coming back. I mean, if you want to know how to do something, how to get somewhere, the fastest way to do that is to get a coach and to get a mentor and to get someone who's done it. I've done television for 20 years. I've done Hangouts since they came out. I've done webinars for 8 years. This is my business model because I just really don't like leaving my cave, and I like doing things that are virtual. And so I don't want to say perfected it, but I've made enough mistakes, and I've taken a lot of bumps and bruises to doing this to kind of figure out how you need to do this and what's going to make it work regardless of your budget. This is not about a lot of money. This is really about expertise and you just having the commitment to go out and do it. So the website is lightscamerahangout.com. Again, that's for these folks only, and that will expire on Friday at midnight. But I'd love to see some of you guys in there, help you work out some of the issues and fears that you might have about doing this, and more importantly, to show you that you can do it. So, Mia, I'm happy to take a couple questions before we sign off.
All right, that sounds good. And then, I mean, you guys know you've never seen me do this before. This is how much I dig what Fran is doing because I'm learning a lot. We've collaborated a lot on different things. I love the office hours idea, Fran. I just think that's brilliant. I think everybody out there that's, you know, thinking about offering something like that, I love that idea because then, you know, mm-hmm. you feel like people can still come and get the info.
Right.
So,
right.
You know, I think so far, this was a great comment from Sunny. This feels like a good reprimand. She's got it crossed out on there. You can't see it. Reminder, feel like I'm in school. I'll be rewatching.
Good.
I love that too. So we're going to go ahead and post that. I just posted the link for your website, but if you go back and post the offer, and then we'll be answering some camera. Oh, you know what, Crystal just corrected me because I had Lads Camera Hangouts. And I even put the wrong thing in.
Way to go, Mia!
It's my show. I'm going to screw it up, right?
There you go.
Thank you, girlfriend, for that, and I'll delete that. But we'll have that information there. So it's been fun. You guys know this is my world. I've made myself into my brand. Fran's been somebody that I've done a lot, like I said, a lot of collaboration with. So I'm going to be taking a look at this, too. But thanks for all the comments, everybody. I think that was really great. Yeah. I think it resonated for a lot of people. And I got to tell you, those four things I've thought about, but I'm in the same boat as Sunny. It's kind of a reprimand reminder. So it was good stuff. Thank you so much.
Any final questions? Anybody got it? We can take one before we sign off.
I did not see any, so just coming through, they're probably down a little bit more. Just honestly, a lot more agreement about this. So if you've watched this and want to kind of pick your brain a little bit more on this, I think here's the great thing. You put it out there so succinctly, it's more everybody's just doing a collective head nod. I gotta tell you.
Good. Okay.
That's when you know you've boomed it out there. So, you guys, this was Fran Harris. I'm Mia Voss talking about HOAs, dough for what you know, and we'll be making comments. Thanks so much.
Bye. Thank you, Mia.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye. It's pretty black and white. It's very straightforward. You can be boring or you can be a badass. That's basically the way I live my life. You can be boring or you can be a badass. So what this, you know, these few minutes are going to be about is helping you to kind of step into your pure badassery, whatever that is, and starting to monetize your hangouts and starting to make money for what you know. So we're going to jump right into what Mia has kind of primed you guys with, which are the four modules of making dough for what you know. The first one is kind of crystallizing your why. But before we even get to the why, crystallizing your who. I mean, who are you? A lot of times people will get on hangouts and they'll attempt to emulate what they've seen someone else do, or they'll try to imitate what they've seen other people do on their hangouts. And I leave going, you know, who was that? I don't think there's any doubt, you guys, and you can put it in the chat bar, you know who Mia is. You know what her persona is because, she, you know, she's bat crap crazy. You never know what she's going to say. That's who she is. So before we can start even talking about what your why is, we have to figure out, you know, who are you? And honestly, get to the point where you know exactly what that persona is, because you can't start to kind of craft what your brand is until you know who you are. Now, as you'll notice, I have on two different earrings. Mia, had you noticed that?
Not a bit.
Of course
you did. I was busy putting on lip gloss and muting myself in the green room.
That's right. But I got to tell you guys a really funny story, and it's relevant to figuring out who you are on the air, okay? So I have on two different earrings. Many years ago, these friends of mine had gone on a small vacation. This couple had gone on a vacation, and they left me with their daughter. That was for is the expertise. Either you're curating the expertise or you're, you know, straight to camera talking about your expertise. So that's kind of how I got to this place. But I will say for the last, I think in 2009, and Mia, you may not even know this, my brother died of a heart attack just suddenly, right? Yeah, just out of the blue died, 51 years old, of a heart attack. And I took some time off, and I actually coached this girl's basketball team. But during that time, the reason I didn't completely lose my mind was that I had the internet to get on and talk about my expertise. And the girl saved my life, but this whole notion of getting paid just to share and help people have bigger lives and bigger businesses by sharing your expertise really was born in 2009. And so that's what brings us to today.
You like to sneak stuff in on me, don't you? Because that's
yeah.
You're like, I can't show you.
You give me sad music.
You're like, I can't show you everything. Hey, I'm going to just jump in with just a couple people. Debbie says it's been way too long since she's seen you. She's here and ready to take notes.
Hi, Debbie.
And then Nazim says, reading the intro on Fran confirmed two fellow badass girls in the house. So we've already got our street cred solidly identified right here. So we're just going to jump in. I'm ready to go. Yeah. We've got some bullet points that are great. I'm going to be over here if we've got some things that we need to pull up from the audience. But I'm ready to get the 411 from you, and then we'll both be kind of jumping in on it. So let's roll.
Excellent. So you guys have rolled with Mia before. If you've rolled with me, if you're coming from my list and my community, or the both of us, you know that we are, you know, by the seat of our pants for the most part with the plan. But it is one wild party here. So I start off this presentation by saying making dough for what you know is really pretty black and white. You know, I don't want to put up my screenshots, but really.
You ready?
I am.
Because I'm going to clap. Right. Hi, guys. I'm Mia Voss, and we're doing a special show today with this gal that I absolutely love. You've seen her on my show a couple times, and we're going to be talking about dough for what you know. Just so you know, I didn't think it up. She did, too. So that's it. So welcome. Welcome, Fran Harris. Hey.
Hello. Thank you, darling. Thank you, darling.
How are you? Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to hit that twice, but, you know, that was from the audience.
It was a standing O. It was a standing O, so that's good.
You've seen them before. All right, so before we jump in, I want to get your, I want to hear your story real quick so everybody who's not seen you on my shows can know why I'm so enamored and have such a girl crush on you.
Well, you know, I grew up in Dallas, Texas. I live now in Austin, Texas, but I grew up in Dallas, Texas, the youngest of four children at the time, and then my parents decided for some crazy reason to have a kid when I was 10 years old. I finally got over that after years of therapy. but I grew up in a great, you know, great family, gregarious family, entrepreneurial family that really inspired me to, you know, the kind of that army slogan of be all you can be, you know, try this, go do that, do whatever you want to do. And after I left college at the University of Texas, I started to understand that people would pay you to come and talk about your expertise. And that's really, even though I didn't call it dough for what you know back then, I learned at a very early age as a college athlete that what people were paying for in the marketplace was expertise. And so when Mia and I met, we were talking about the fact that we were, you know, she was doing hangouts a little bit more than I was. I was doing webinars a lot more than she was. And I said, you know what, people are tuning in with who you are. I mean, you got to be okay with who you are, because in a sea of millions of, eventually millions of hangouts, what you're going to have a difficult time doing is breaking through the noise. And Mia, you may be able to identify with this right now. I mean, when we first started doing hangouts, you know, I'm going to make up some numbers. There were, you know, two people doing them, three people doing them. Now there are 3,000 people doing them by the end of the month. So part of your challenge with doing this stuff is distinction in the marketplace. Mm-hmm. Are you going to be afraid to put on two different earrings? Are you going to be afraid to put on the striped pants and the polka dot shirt if that's truly who you are? So the first thing I want to say is, know who you are. The marketplace needs to know who you are. And then the second thing is, you know, what is it, what's unique about what you're bringing to the marketplace? If I share some of the things I talk about on stages all over the world, I always say there are only three different ways to be different. Your message has to be different, the messenger has to be different, or the method is different. That's it. Those are the only three ways to be different.
Right.
You, the messenger, is different, your message is different, or the way you do things, your method is different. So,
can I jump in here and ask a question or clarification? I think it's also good. I know for myself, when I started doing the hangouts, again, this was 8 months ago, there weren't as many. This is definitely the year. I have it on my banner on my other show. It's, you know, the year of the HOA. So a lot of people are doing that. So I definitely suggest too, of like this balance of doing your homework and seeing what's out there that's in your arena once you get a little more clarified. But then again, you got to just, and for me, I had to do it too, because I was seeing that it was very male dominated. That was a show that we did on gender diversity. Remember the back in February, super male
scary. They left me to kind of take care of their daughter, and their daughter wanted to wear like these polka dot pants and this striped shirt to school the next day. And so she said, this is my favorite shirt, these are my favorite pants, and this is what I want to wear. And so I let her wear. And so, you know, she was happy. She had the polka dot pants and a striped shirt. And I let her wear those because that was her. That was uniquely her. And I wasn't going to allow the distractions of what people might think and what they might say, because that was that kid. Mm-hmm. Now, of course, when my friends got back, the wife was like, you did what? Let my daughter leave this.
Was it like picture day, too? They're like, what is that kid wearing? Actually, and I need to point out what's funny is that you said they left you with their daughter, which I love. That would be me, too. I'm going to leave you
with her. That's right. That's right. Well, the mom was like, what did you let her wear? What? And I was like, yeah, I let her wear the polka dot pants and the striped shirt because that's her identity. And the dad was like, he was chuckling, right? He was just like, you're going to get in trouble. But I was like, this is my opportunity to give you a lesson, parents, in personal identity and branding.
I love
that. That is a great branding lesson, because that kid wanted to be herself. And there's no reason. Sometimes we go out there and we go, well, we don't want to do this because, you know, what are people going to say? What are people going to do? If you're too crazy, Mia, people mm-hmm. are not going to want to watch your show, Fran. If you're wearing two different earrings or if you're too loud, people are not going to. That's who I am. Mm-hmm. What I did with that kid is who I am, but it was also who she was. And so the first part of this, before we start even talking about making dough for it to know and monetizing, is figure out who you are and be okay.